Yeah, the group of 55 buoys which you see here is known as the Tau Array, Tau standing for Tropical Atmosphere Ocean. Each buoy measures wind, relative humidity, and temperature, as well as ocean temperatures down to 500 meters. Now, that information combined with satellite observations helps forecasters determine whether an El Nino or a La Nina pattern may emerge. Both can have an influence on long-term global weather patterns. The update, happening over the next 4 years, will include upgraded instruments allowing for new and higher quality observations. That includes rainfall measurements. Here's Tau Program Manager Dr. Karen Grissom to explain why that's important.
Say the model says you're going to get 10 inches of rain across the tropical Pacific during any one event. We don't know that for sure unless we happen to have a ship out there that's actually measuring rain. But now we will have buoys out across the tropical Pacific. They'll be monitoring the rain. We'll be able to look at the observations collected from those buoys and compare them to the model output. And if there is a difference between the two, we'll be able to go back to our models and recalibrate our models based upon the data that's coming from these buoys.
And that model recalibration can ultimately lead to more reliable El Nino and La Nina forecasts, which are made months in advance. An accurate forecast with a long lead time like that is crucial because weather patterns driven by El Nino and La Nina can significantly impact major parts of the global economy, including shipping and the fishing industry. And of course, in our neck of the woods, we pay attention to the El Nino cycle for potential hints about the coming winter. Right now, forecasters with NOAA are projecting about a 60% chance for an El Nino to develop later this year, possibly extending into the winter. Now, that can result in wetter than average conditions in southern parts of the United States and warmer than average conditions in the northern part of the country. Notice, though, Northern California isn't included in either of those areas. A good reminder that El Nino for us is just one factor in seasonal forecasting, a science that still comes with a lot of uncertainties. Back to you.
Heather, thank you.